2 years later against Thailand's Chamorun Songkhet in Bangkok. The bout was contested under a pouring rain, and the fighters, concerned with traction, duked it out in their bare feet. Another world bantamweight champion, Lionel Rose, seemed somewhat confused by this 1969 publicity stunt in Los Angeles. In the ring, however, boxing's first Aborigine titleist was quite sure of himself. Australia's most popular fighter was also its most accomplished. In the mid-80s, Jeff Fenwick won world titles in 3 weight classes, exhibiting an animal-like ferocity. Fenwick should have won a 4th crown, but was denied when the judges scored his dominant performance against Azuma Nelson a draw. Today, there is only one Australian world champion, WBC light heavyweight king Jeff Harding. With Fenwick in retirement, it's time for a new hero from down under to get over. Don't be surprised if that fighter is Russian-born lightweight Kostya Zou. Indications are that he has the talent to make Australia's boxing tradition even richer. This is Steve Farhood for The Ring Magazine.
Adopted Australian Kostya Zou making his American TV debut against tough Hector Lopez coming up next in our main event.
USA Tuesday night fights really knocked me out.
For the main event on a beautiful night in downtown Tampa, Florida, Budweiser, the King of Beers, presents USA's Tuesday Night Fights. 2 world-rated junior welterweights, Russian sensation Kostya Zou against the flying fists of Hector Lopez. Hector Lopez is coming off a spectacular show with a devastating 3rd-round knockout to win an NABF title. But Lopez would not wear the new belt, testing positive for marijuana, which he now claims has changed his life.
I've been going to church a lot. Believe me, it's helped me a lot. Just to see life differently, you know, put my priorities differently and what I want to do and what I want to accomplish. And I feel that this fight is very important to me because this kid's so highly rated, you know. You know, I just don't know that he can't even go a distance with me because I think I can beat him and stop him, to tell you the truth. But we'll just get out to go out there and fight, take care of business, whatever angle comes about, you know?
Lopez fears no one in the ring, even the newest golden boy, Kostya Zou. Lopez, also world-ranked, feels he has the edge against the younger fighter.
My experience is going to come in. And even not just that, like I said, if I wanted to just go out there and just bang with him, we can do that too, and I can beat him at it. I can beat him at any which way he wants to go. If he wants to box, he cannot box me. If he wants to trade, it's okay. But I think that the bottom line is that I'm going to control the fight, and my experience is going to control the fight, and it's going to be set at my tempo. And when I want to pull the cord, I'll pull it.
This is the fighter Hector Lopez is talking about, and many people in the boxing world starting to talk about. Who is Kostya Zou? If a Hollywood studio wanted to make a movie about this fighter, it could be called From Russia with Glove. Kostya Zou comes to America with international fanfare and an enormous talent. Tampa, Florida is a far cry from his roots. Zou was born in the little Russian town called Serov near Siberia. His father made his living ice fishing during the brutal Russian winters. As a young boy, Kostya and his family endured all the hardships associated under the iron clamp of communist rule, like waiting on long food lines, not knowing if food would be available or affordable. As he grew older, he went on to serve in the Russian army, where he also enjoyed certain athletic privileges, showing an affinity towards boxing, demonstrating sensational talent. His fighting skills were first noticed in the recent World Championships and caught the eye of Australian promoter Bill Morty, who brought Sue and his family up to a better way of life by moving down under to Australia.
A special athlete will come along, perhaps once in a lifetime. I thought we had it with Jeff Fannick, but now I think we've struck it a double because Kostya Zou, I think, will win the world title.
Zou felt confident about the move, knowing he would now get the opportunity to showcase his flair in the ring.
If I wasn't sure, I wouldn't have come to Australia. I'm sure that I can be a champion, 100%.
Working with veteran trainer Johnny Lewis, Zou is undefeated in his first 10 pro fights, 8 of them by knockout, 7 of those knockouts in the first 2 rounds. His lightning speed and marvelous flair has caught the fancy of the Australian boxing fans and the world sanctioning bodies. The IBF ranks him number 3 in the junior welterweight division. The WBC lists him number 4. His powerful punches are not lost on his respectful but beaten opponents.
I mean, I've been fighting for a while. I've been hit by a lot bigger guys and didn't go anywhere. And this punch, I didn't see it. And that's all she wrote.
Like a cobra.
Like a cobra. Like an elephant. Heavy. Boom. That's it.
Outside the ring, Zou is now living the good life. Food and money no longer a problem for Kostya and his wife, Natasha, as they adapt to their new living environment. Knowing the importance of speaking the language of their adopted country, the two travel each week to class to increase their vocabulary and proficiency in English.
This is what I do every day.
This is what I do every day.
First, I get up about 5 or 6 o'clock.
First, I get up at about 5 or 6 o'clock.
Okay. In a sport searching for stars with charisma, Zou could be boxing's next colorful attraction. Tonight, he's introduced to the American audience. This junior welterweight has the potential to be boxing's biggest little international star.
Taking him from a country where, you know, things are very, very tough, and introduce him to the greatest country in the world, and hopefully that the people will support him and get behind him, because I know that he will one day be a credit to our country.
My ambition is, with Kostya, to take him back to Moscow in the Red Square, 100,000 people, watching him become the first Russian to ever win a world professional boxing championship.
So, Sean, why is Kostya Zou considered this phenom sensation?
Well, this is a sport, Al, that a lot of people talk, but very few people prove. This is a young man who has already proven, and he hasn't talked at all. What he needs now, though, is exposure and experience. Tonight, from Hector Lopez, he'll get the experience, but if this fight goes late, he will, with USA, get the exposure. They're already talking about him fighting for the championship of the world after only 10 fights.
Now watch the entrance of Kostya Zou. He always does the high jump over the top rope, and I must say, the ropes are very high here tonight. So we'll see if Kostya Zou, he's getting his leverage, taking a look. It's a 2.7 degree difficulty, and he is in. The amazing thing about Kostya Zou, not only the fact that he has beaten Juan Laporte in his fourth professional fight, put Bramble down in the first round and beat him in his 10th fight, but I feel the moxie of a guy in just 10 professional fights even stepping in the ring against such veterans as Laporte and Bramble.
Oh, well, he knows what he can do, and with Johnny Lewis, his trainer, he realizes how important it is to listen to that corner and rely on their experience. Now, this is a man that has grown up around the world, yes, but he is from Russia. He doesn't have any idea who Hector Lopez is. He doesn't. He has done his homework. He studied Hector Lopez, but he doesn't hear the reputation of a Hector Lopez, a Livingstone Bramble, or a Juan Laporte.
Now, Lopez can't believe a kid of 10 professional fights can come in here and outlast his survival instincts.
Yeah, well, he's been in there with a lot of top fighters himself. He's fought for a world championship, This is a man who's got a lot of experience, and he cannot fathom a young kid coming right out of the amateurs into professional boxing and teaching him his game.
He has more experience than tattoos. That's how experienced Hector Lopez is. Let's check out these two fighters on the tail of the tape. And Lopez also thinks that his strength, along with the experience, will get him by. And as you can see, he is the bigger of the two fighters. The rules here in Florida. No standing eight count, three knockdown rule is in effect. You can be saved by the bell only in the final round, and it's a scoring of the 10-point must scoring system. Now, how does the champ set up these two fighters strategically on the blackboard? Let's find out. Champ, give it to us.
Brought to you by Pringles Potato Chips, tonight's boxing blackboard. Cost you zoo. Don't slug. Use speed first. Make Hector believe he's too slow. And play box in the early rounds. Show us what you have, then power late, Zoo. While you tell Hector Lopez, each round you stay, Hector, it's gonna cost you. Hector Lopez, you must take this fight and your opponent in the trenches. Slow him down with early body shots. Reach down carefully, but steal his power. Confuse him, Hector. You're the veteran. Push, pull, and punch. Make him work early so he'll be tired late. Then come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Acree and Alessi Promotions, in association with Budweiser, the undisputed king of beers, presents main event, 10 rounds, junior welterweights. Your judges at ringside are Don Ballas of Clearwater, Florida, of Tampa, Florida, Daryl Brown, and from Leesburg, Florida, Frank Skillbred. Your referee for this event, from Tampa, Florida, Brian Gary. Introducing first, in the red corner to my right, wearing the blue trunks with white accessories, black trim. He weighs 142 and 3 quarter pounds. Professional record, 25 victories, 2 defeats, 1 draw. He has 12 knockouts. El Hijo de la República de México, now making his home in Los Angeles, California. He is ranked number 8 in the world by the WBA, number 6 by the WBC, Hector El Torero López. His opponent, wearing the black trunks, white accessories, he weighs 139 and one half pounds. He is undefeated in 10 professional bouts. He has 8 knockouts. From Sarov, Russia, now making his home in Sydney, Australia. He is ranked number 4 by the WBC, number 3 by the IBF. Here is Konstantin Kostya Su. Su. 10 rounds, junior welterweights.
Come on out, Constantine. Come on out. Okay, Hector. Gentlemen, I'll be the third man in the ring in charge of the bout at all times. If you score a knockdown, go to the neutral corner. Avoid the use of your head, no rabbit punches, no low blows. Good luck. Come out boxing at the bell. Let's go.
For the first time in his pro career, Kostya Su, hearing the boos from the crowd, gets a hug and a kiss from the veteran trainer, Johnny Lewis, who I guess you would call the zookeeper. And Su, who is on the road. He has 10 victories in 10 fights, 9 of them in Australia. He has a victory here in the U.S. back in January of 93 when he knocked out Steve Larimore in Tennessee in the second round. So he has spent time in the U.S. And, you know, looking at some of the highlights, and you see Su here, especially with the ponytail, a bit of a reminder of Jorge Paez, has that kind of action style in the ring. And he is going up against a live wire in Hector Lopez. This is a terrific matchup.
Real tough, Hector Lopez. Lopez said, I have so many styles that tonight I think I'll box unless he wants to get busy. Rather stay on the inside and slug war with his opponent.
Hector Lopez, top rank, number 6 by the WBC, number 8 by the WBA, so a victory over Su also lofts him into a position to be watched by world champions Julio Cesar Chavez, Charles Murray, and Juan Cochi are the junior welterweight champs across the board. Hector Lopez likes to get inside and likes to wear his opponent down.
He likes to get on the inside, but in doing that, occasionally he will eat some punches. Said he's not afraid to get hit. He's been hit before. He said, I'm a professional. I'll take two and give mine one.
Hector Lopez has a strong chin. He has never been knocked down. And he'll go low if he has to early.
Low blow, however, it was Costa also pushing over with his left hand. Not all the fault of Lopez.
Zhu impeccable in his victories over Juan Laporte.
General Freak!
Shut him out in the fight, as he did against Livingstone Bramble. He also knocked out former contender Sammy Fuentes in 70 seconds of the first round. So Zhu has put impressive numbers up there, but tonight he faces his toughest opponent in Hector Lopez. Laporte and Bramble, certainly their best days behind them, but still a fighter of 10 fights or four fights when he fought Laporte, would very rarely step in against experienced fighters like those two.
Oh yeah. So the power comes from within. He says, Constantine Zhu says, I have great balance inside the ropes. You can't see that. Good movement. He also does a nice little thing. Once you step backwards, he allows for Hector to come in, and then he punches, getting the full extension on his shots. And watch him walk his opponent. Get your opponent out there in the end of your punches, and then you just simply walk around while you're throwing punches. Let him walk into something. You get the angle on him, he doesn't have the angle on you.
And Zhu has great power, knockout power in both hands. Round one comes to a close. Not an empty seat in the house at the Hyatt. And they have come to see this sensation, Kostya Zhu, and Hector Lopez trying to turn off the lights of the sparkling sensation.
Yeah, Lopez doing a great job moving in and getting downstairs to the body. You have to get your opponent's body, take that body away from him, take his heart away from him, and then he stands and sludges with you. Then you can clobber him. The movement is going to give Lopez all kinds of trouble. That angle that Zhu gets, watch him walk around, that is very pretty. That's very professional. Good. This is what they call ring savvy, ring generalship. You know just where you are in the ring. You know where those ropes are on your back. You know how to move. You step around your opponent, you walk him. I mean, when you think about this kid, this is his 11th professional fight, and he's in there with Hector Lopez.
The 29th professional fight for Hector Lopez. He has fought 211 rounds coming into this fight to 36 by Kostya Zhu.
Yeah, and Hector Lopez knew that Zhu was going to come out strong at first. He wanted to be patient at first, be cautious, move in, hands up, put the pressure on, go downstairs to the body, but build up a good long-range fight plan, fight attack. He wants to build it, a slow build, get off of him. No elbowing.
Look at the patience.
You know, and Hector Lopez got to be saying, come on, let's fight.
Yeah, but
let me use the elbows.
Zhu showing tremendous patience.
Yeah, good. This is ring generalship. Ring savvy. Look at, just move just enough to take the power out of your opponent's punch. You don't move a lot. We didn't get out of the way of that one.
There's that straight right by Lopez, who has 12 knockouts in his 25 victories. He's a L.A. Olympian back in 88. He represented Mexico in the Olympics and went to the finals before losing to Mauricio Stecca. Silver medal for Hector Lopez. He turned pro with 10 straight victories before losing a 12-rounder in his 11th fight to George Navarro. He would go undefeated in the next 15, including an NABF title against then undefeated 27-0 Donald Stokes. And that lifted Lopez into a world championship fight, and he just shows you his repertoire going behind the back. He might have picked that up from Magic Johnson living in Los Angeles. But Lopez fought Miguel Gonzalez for the WBC lightweight crown. That was back last April. Had Gonzalez in trouble, nearly out early, but Gonzalez came back to win the 12-rounder. the next fight was the victory over David Santos to win that NABF crown. That was the last fight for Hector Lopez. And he is looking now for a world title fight as a junior welterweight.
Giving more room this round. He said he has a lot of styles. Well, when you're frustrated, you will revert to sometimes dirty tactics. Here it is, going around the back. Constanzu did not like that. Made him angry. Now, the trainer of Constanzu, Johnny Lewis, said that Constanzu's eyes are steely cold. He said a lot like the great Roberto Duran. I mean, when he gets in there and he gets ready to fight, his eyes tell the whole story. He's 100% focused on his opponent. And that is what's happened through two rounds of this fight. However, Lopez, gotta give him credit, he's put the pressure on. He has changed his styles, he adapted in that second round. And he's tough.
Keep him up, Jeff.
Heavy punches. Now you gotta go down there to the body. Take the power out of the shots from Zhu. Zhu is too hard a hitter to stand there and trade with him. It comes from Savvy. 5-2-1, Hector Lopez.
Lopez wants Zhu to get into a trade fest. Good work. Something
that.
Like that.
Yeah, right-handed pivot. Very nice work from him. You step around, you get the angle on your opponent. For professional boxers, the fight does not start until 3. You're in the third round, and you see Lopez starting to pick it up a little bit more. Zhu has to fight back.
That's good.
Lopez crowding on the ropes, and the Zhu on the break, giving Lopez a little bit of his own medicine.
Really good.
As a young fighter, Zhu has been compared to Oscar De La Hoya, of guys of coming out of the Olympics, and where De La Hoya stands in the boxing world as a very young fighter.
And I can see why. Both of them fight a lot alike. They both step around, they both get the angles, both have their hands low, both have good head movement, both great balance.
And both look pretty much like seasoned pros.
Yeah, and both of them still trying to prove in their career. They are the world champions.
Zhu is 24 years of age. He passed up the Olympics in Barcelona. Decided that he actually had accomplished all he could as an amateur and wanted to get into the pro ranks. He had nearly 300 amateur fights, won 279, and lost 11. And those losses were early. He was the 1991 World Amateur Champion. And he is in and out. Closing seconds in round 3. This is scheduled for 10. The King of Beers presents USA's Tuesday Night Fights, and this is our main event and a marvelous matchup. Two fighters putting it on the line here tonight. Constanzu, the sensation from Russia, now training and living in Australia. Won his first 10 fights impressively, is already ranked number 3 in the world as a junior welterweight. Hector Lopez, who's ranked as high as number 6 as a junior welter. and he is trying to derail the so-called phenom and put his name into the championship picture. And at the side always of Kostya Zhu, his lovely wife Natasha, who gets into this fight as she makes her trip over with her husband to the U.S., his first American TV fight. And Natasha's first American TV appearance.
Look at the movement from her. Get out of the way of these punches. You know, this is the movement that Zhu uses. In boxing, we refer to it as a ball. What you want to do in that ring is you want to spin on your ball. Like, imagine you have a great big basketball in your belly, and you can move on that ball any way that a ball would move. You move your head. That way, you conserve the energy of moving your feet. You just move your head.
One of the terrific things about this matchup, Sean, we've talked about so many times before, we see it so many times, are the good fighters ducking other good fighters. Lopez almost went behind the back.
Then he thought about it.
Again.
You know, you throw these punches, and if you think about where you're going to hit, the opening's gone, even if it's behind your back. If you think about it, you can't do it.
But so many fighters plotting their course, and they get too careful about who they fight. And that actually just shows the lack of confidence in themselves. But here's two fighters in different reasons. You could ask, why are they facing one another? But hats off to them.
Exactly. But I'm telling you right now, Al, it's not the fighters. Fighters will fight any living human being and most animals. It is not the fighters that won't fight. It's the promoters and the managers that won't fight. The fighters will face anybody. It's not up to them. It's up to the promoters and managers.
30 seconds to go in round number four.
Ooh, good body punch. Digging in. Hector Lopez downstairs. Not so much movement this round from Zhu.
Lopez says if it comes down to strength, he won't push me around. And I'm just going to get in there and counter, pick him apart little by little, and take over later in this fight.
Nice on his back, mate. Shut your eyes, Cos. Shut your eyes. Watch your head to that, Cos. Watch the jabs on. Every time you jab, you hit him too, mate. So when you want a little bit of a breath and you move around the ring, just keep the jab going.
It's scheduled for 10. This is round number five, and they quickly meet in the middle. In the black trunks, 10-0, Kostya Zhu. And in the blue trunks, 25-2-1, Hector Lopez. Both ranked in the top 10 as junior welterweights. Ooh, good right hand there by Zhu. Lopez got caught coming in.
Good right hand, and Lopez comes back. Zhu's punches are on the inside. Lopez trying to go outside. A fight, yes, but a battle of wills, too. Try to impose your will on your opponent. Oh, good combinations upstairs and downstairs from Zhu. You got to be careful if you're Lopez. You don't want to stay just at that long distance. 90% of the power of the punch is right on the end. You want to get either all the way in, which he tries to do, or all the way out. You know, and we've seen, remember that second round? Remember when he was moving a little bit more, giving ground? Now he's reverted back to the way Hector Lopez loves to fight. Battle.
And you'll see that a lot from Zhu, where carries the hands low and avoids punches just with his head movement.
Just by you moving his head. You know, you don't have to move your head 8 inches. inches to get out of the way of a punch. You have to move it just enough to take the power out of it, and then you're still in range to score, to counter. Oh, good right hand by Lopez. Now, Lopez is landing in this round. He's landing, and he is moving forward, and this is the part of the fight that he was waiting for. Zeus still stepping around. What Lopez might do is slide his feet over, stop that run. You gotta corner your man up. Now you slide over with the right foot. See how Zeus walks around him? Good left hooks. This is a good matchup.
Zeus off balance for the moment. You don't see that often. And Lopez able to connect. Lopez left scoring on a couple occasions here.
Good work from Lopez, but it is Lopez that sounds like a steam engine in the ring. He is breathing heavy.
Last fight for Lopez was in July. Zhu's last fight, the victory over Bramble, was in August. So they've each had some time off.
It is harder to knock out those strong opponents that are strong, physically strong, like Hector Lopez is. His punches hurt, and you can't, when you connect, they don't wobble.
Next couple of rounds, plenty of jabbing on him too, Cost. Keep your heat.
Big round for Hector Lopez. He muscled, he pushed, pulled, he got on the inside, and then boom. Big left hook. Now with those fighters, they keep their hands low like Zhu does. You keep your hands down by your waist, you try to move your head, you will occasionally get caught.
Little concern in the corner of Costa Zhu. Came back to the corner, Johnny Lewis saying, just got a couple of rounds left. Trying to pick up the pace here in the sixth. Lopez certainly picking up the pace.
Yeah, you have to remember that the hand is quicker than the eye. So when you carry your hands low, you got to be able to move your head quick or bring those hands up.
Crafty, hard-nosed Hector Lopez says, I don't care what I hear about Costa Zhu. I've got the tools, I've got the experience, I'll be able to handle whatever he throws at me.
And I've never seen him so confident for a fight. I'm talking to him yyesterday and today, he was like, ready to go, let's get it on tonight. He was so fired up for this because he believes that Zhu is just a pumped up publicity machine. But Zhu, I can tell you, very good fighter. Very pretty to watch. Good looking young prospect.
You had asked Zhu about how come you're fighting a guy like Hector Lopez in just your 11th fight, and he kind of gave you a blank stare and he says, I'm a fighter. I'm going to fight.
Yeah, again, it goes back to what we were talking about. He doesn't know who Hector Lopez is. Other than the ratings, he's not, although he did his homework on this fight, he's not impressed with Hector Lopez.
I think he is impressed. He certainly he has respect going in, but he feels that's his job. He's a fighter.
Right.
I mean, he feels I'm ranked ahead of him.
Yeah, and that is.
But Costa Zhu is now bleeding from the mouth. Lopez discounts Zhu's victory over Bramble. He says Bramble came out just to survive. Anybody could look good if you hit the bag and the bag doesn't hit back. And now the chant from the crowd of Lopez, Lopez. Born in Mexico City, moved to LA when he was only 3 years of age. The family moved up there, that's where he grew up. And now finding fans here in Florida.
Oh yeah, well I appreciate the fighting that he's putting up. He's fighting him. This is his fight plan. This is what he wanted to do coming into this match, and he is doing it.
You know, you lay in bed and you wait for the big night where you're going to fight. You think about what you're going to do. You concentrate. You get your fight plan built up. And then you go in there and you do it. Nice to see.
Head into the seventh round. This appears to be a very close fight. Kostyuzhu, the Russian sensation, now fighting out of Australia in the black trunks with a 10-0 record, 8 knockouts. 7 of those had come in the first 2 rounds. Hector Lopez, 25-2-1 with 12 KOs. One of his losses, a world championship fight. And a 12-round loss to Miguel Gonzalez last April for that title.
Yeah, who heard a happy man in his corner between rounds. Harry Kasangian said his hands are low, talking about Zhu. He said he's breathing heavy. Stay on him. Keep the pressure on. Keep hitting him with shots like that. Good punch.
The reflexes of Zhu slowing down.
Yeah, I go back to the hands low and also the chin up in the air of Zhu. You want to try to tuck that chin, keep that chin down. Protect it with those shoulders. If you're going to keep your hands down like that, use them shoulders. Roll around with them.
And even the hand speed you can see here of Zhu, he is being punches. Beaten to the punch by Lopez.
The body shots, they take all the speed out of you. They take the power out of your punch. Hurt.
Look at right under the left eye of Zhu. Lopez now bouncing on his toe, feeling more and more confident.
Yep, you can see swelling at the Zhu.
Let's go, Zhu!
I got you, gentlemen. A punch!
Close fight, good matchup, battle back and forth. I have the score so far through 6-3-3. Seventh round, but has the tie turned. It was that fourth round that Zhu had a good round, but then since the fifth round, he's not been very effective. Although he has landed some good heavy blows right at the bell. Especially in that fifth round, they could have won in the round. Very close.
Well, he's being beaten to the punch. He's being outboxed.
Yeah.
And he's going up against a guy in Lopez who has never been down in a fight.
Step out. Step out.
So this assignment starting to look pretty tough for Kostyuzhu.
Well, it could be very Kostya.
Or something like that. Jab opening things up for Hector Lopez in this fight.
Now the pot shot shots working from Hector Lopez, but he changed his style in this round. Is that going to give Zhu enough to recuperate? You know, they told Hector Lopez, stay on him.
All right.
Very busy in the corner.
Yeah, tell me the truth, man. It's all right.
Austin Team Zhu. That is the back of Johnny Lewis.
The next 3 rounds, but man, you must win them, okay? Very good hit, man. Keep your hands up. The water, mate, plenty of water. Just have a good gargle, mate. Spit it out. Spit it out there. What's the boy? Hey? Vaseline and the mouth guard. Vaseline first.
This is the number one trainer in Australia, Johnny Lewis. Has had fighters like Jeff Fennec, Jeff Harding, even trained Virgil Hill for a while.
Take the bucket.
He said that Kostyuzhu does everything he should do
right
to be a fighter. He said he is the perfect boxer. But the perfect boxer is getting some good pot shots from Hector Lopez, who's shooting the punches from long range.
He has a 5-inch reach advantage, and he is using it effectively. Eighth round scheduled, 10-rounder. And the veteran Hector Lopez coming on in the mid rounds. Kostyuzhu has explosive hooks. And he may have to pull them out here.
Let's go, Kostyuzhu!
His wife, Natasha.
Very worried, and she's getting a good workout over there, too. Worried for good reason. Good movement. How would you like to sit next to her? She's like all night going to be punching her arm, moving over.
Well, she may record a knockout before Kostya does here tonight.
Yeah, there she is. Get the hands up. Oh, that is so hard. Oh, please, she's saying.
Into the pleading mode.
Yeah, oh, that's so hard. You know, in the fight, a boxer gets to release his energy. The wife over in the crowd doesn't get that release. She doesn't get that physical workout. The corner men don't get that release.
And she has also not seen her husband, Kostya Zou, in this tough of a fight.
Oh, yeah. Good combination on the inside. Good work. Well, she's doing something right because Zou is landing good clean shots.
Zou needs something dramatic to turn this back. And he's trying to open up. He does load up on his shots.
Yeah, but now he has slowed down. And when he slowed down, he's throwing his punches, but he's ending up so close on his opponent. His opponent can just grab him, or Zou can grab Hector.
And that's what Lopez is doing after each
assault. This comes from fatigue. Hector Lopez is taking a break this round. But inexperience, Konstantin Zou is causing this to happen. Good left hook, still has power, still dangerous. That is the thing about fighting a man that is considered a puncher. He can always end the fight or he can turn the tide of a fight.
Yeah, but he has 8 knockouts in his 10 fights, but none of them have come this late in a fight.
Got the snap on his shots.
I don't know if Natasha thought there would be many nights like this as Hector Lopez taking it to her husband, Kostya Zou.
I told you how she was getting a good workout over there. Look at her keeping her chin down. She's putting her chin down like she knows Konstantin is supposed to do.
Well, she's fundamentally sound.
And see the clock in her hand, the watch? She's timing these rounds and telling Konstantin when there's 15 seconds left so that Kostya can score and try to win the round. There's a old professional trick. You try to win that last few seconds of the round. Try to win the round, and you also send your opponent back to his corner.
That was a slipper, a pushdown, but still might be the psychological turn for Zou in seeing Lopez drop to the canvas.
Whatever you can do to get your opponent down there to the canvas.
Oh, nice left hand, a jumping left hand by Zou. Kostya Zou coming in with all the publicity as the phenom, the sensation, 10-0 in 10 pro fights, ranked all the way up at number 3 in the world. But it appears as if he has to pull it out here against the hard-nosed, also top 10 ranked, Hector Lopez. Knows all the tricks.
And down again.
Zou wants the knockdown.
Yeah, it's a slip. You put your opponent on the canvas. Psychologically, it tells you that between rounds, I overheard Harry Kasserdian in the corner of Lopez saying, go out there and just coast through this round. If you have to lose a round, do it this round. What the old-time veteran trainers tell their fighters, if you're going to coast the next to last round and come on strong in the final round.
But it meant to say you could lose the round, not lose the fight in this round.
Well, I couldn't tell if he was saying coast or coast you. Coast you this round.
Hector Lopez has had 3 times as many fights as Zou, 7 times as many rounds. He has fought a world championship.
And he is definitely taking a break this round. Zou is not. Zou says, I need this round. Big punches from him this round.
And he already has this round. Zou coming on strong here in the ninth.
He may get the knockout. He still has power, Al.
combination of Lopez taking the round off and Zhu knowing he has to come on strong the last two rounds.
Very powerful young man.
No, let me have it.
Heads coming together.
That's the heads.
Work your hands, Zhu.
Final 10 seconds of the ninth round. Zhu looking to come on strong, even though he appears to have clinched this ninth round.
Oh.
And the drama builds with nine rounds down, one round to go. Let's listen in to the corners.
Right, we're gonna win at this round, son. Give us the water. The water. Spit this out, son. Spit this out. Spit it out. Costa, we must work under and bring the uppercut. You feeling good?
Yeah.
Feeling like a champion? You've got to win this round. You're a champion, understand? You know what you are, a champion. Come on, Costa.
Positive reinforcement.
From a champion, that's all I'm asking from
you. Give your fighter a PMA, a positive mental attitude.
Costa, we must win this round, mate. You've got him out on his feet.
Final round now, gentlemen. Let's give it a go now.
Costa, the big right uppercut in close. Jab him hard, mate. Hit the points. We must win the points. Come on, son. Hit him hard underneath, Costa. Please, mate. I got love you, Costa. Come on, get him up. Get him up, son.
When you're fighting, you're like thinking, mate, how come you're not getting hit in these punches? I'm getting hit every time, mate.
And you see the crescendo even in the corner. Johnny Lewis quiet during the early rounds, and he has built it to a feverish pitch and hoping that his fighter picks up on that in that
10th
and
right
final
hand.
Round.
Very good.
Well, we said that Costa Zhu looks a little like Jorge Paez physically and also stylistically.
And his hair.
And the hair. Thank you, champ. And remember the Jorge Paez who came on strong in a fight with Calvin Grove in that final round to pull out a fight. And a championship.
Oh, both of them. Both of them heard the same thing from their corners between rounds. You need this round.
And
I've got the fight scored extremely close, 4-4-1 through nine rounds.
And Zhu is now beating Lopez to the punch.
This is the round, you give it everything you got, and it's because Zhu is on the inside with his punches. Oh, there, Brian Gary gets a shot. Whoops.
There's enough to go around for everybody here in this fight. And Brian getting very careful, breaking up the two fighters.
Oh, this is it. Both of them know it.
Now Zhu muscling Lopez. Well, did Lopez take the ninth round off, or has he run out of gas?
Well, remember I told you earlier in the fight he was breathing extremely heavy.
I'll tell you, Lopez.
Many times when a fighter is so excited about getting in the ring, they leave that energy in the hotel room the day of the fight. He did lay down. He took a nap today. But he was very excited about having this amateur kid come in and fight him, Hector Lopez.
Lopez could run out of gas and still give you another five rounds.
There it is, behind the back and in front of the back. No more of that.
You know what? Lopez can't risk getting a point taken away here.
But Lopez says, wait a minute, Constantine hit the referee. I should be able to hit my back. Has Constantine punched himself out?
Well, he runs into that shot. I kind of wish this was a 12-rounder.
We do. Thank
you. Down to 35 seconds left in the fight. Two Warriors.
Yeah, good crawl. Tuesday night's all about.
I got you. No punch. Step back.
Worth the wait. Final 20 seconds.
No knockdowns in this fight.
Boom.
And there will be no knockouts. And Lopez ends it with a low blow. Wants to make sure there's no finishing flurry by Zhu.
Yeah.
10 rounds. Action-packed as advertised. And now Costa Zhu, for the first time as a pro, heads into his corner wondering if he is still undefeated.
Costa, let's all settle down. Let's all settle. I want to wipe his face, please.
Well, the slate was clean coming into this fight. Checking into then and now, a clean record and a clean face of Kostyuzu. But after 10 rounds against the on-charging Hector Lopez, this is what Zhu looks like after the 30 minutes of action.
Yeah, you can see what caused it. The jabs caused the puffiness on the right side of the face of Zhu, and the overhand rights caused the puffiness on the left side of the face of Zhu.
And
he's
Zhu,
tough, and the crowd appreciates him. Well, some of them do.
Able to smile after the 10 rounds, his toughest fight as a pro. Is he still undefeated? Let's find out. We'll go to Mark Biro for the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision. Judge Tom Brown scores it 97-94. Judge Don Ballas scores it 99-92. Judge Frank Skillbred scores it 97-93. All to the winner, Konstantin Kostyuzu.
Lopez just turns away, 99-92. Wow. And Zhu hears the boos of some of the crowd, and Lopez wants nothing to do with it, and he exits stage left immediately. Unanimous decision for Kostyuzu, 97-94, 97-93, and 99-92. It looked certainly much closer from this angle.
Well, I had it much closer. I had 4-4-1 in rounds. I had the fight extremely close in 97-94, 99-92, 97-93. Judges, all three judges had it, a wide margin for Konstantin Zhu.
Natasha saying, I didn't know it was going to be like this.
She didn't know it was going to be that wide either. She must have had it close also.
So Zhu goes to 11-0, outlasts Hector Lopez in what we have to consider a controversial decision. I'm sure many felt that Lopez won that fight. Now it's time to take a look at the Power Punch, brought to you by Budweiser. Fresh, pure, natural, proud to be your Bud. And we go back to our first fight tonight, seemed like years ago. Ralph Jones in the black trunks, 16-1 entering this fight. And early in the third round, he puts Terry Ford through the ropes. Stays with it, gets that extra punch in, and Ford goes through the ropes, was able to find his way back in, but that was a mistake, because just seconds later, Ford is wide open to the left. Max Parker Jr. steps right in. That would be the last punch of the fight. 17-1, Ralph Jones, and he supplies us with not just the, but those power punches of the night.